Okie doke, try this again. I filmed, or I thought I was filming me doing this floating cut pour for this particular piece. I was so happy with it. I've got some real nice pearl cells kind of pop up in it. And then when I checked my camera, it wasn't running. So I'm gonna do another one exactly the same method as I just did. On the same size canvas, because I can always put them together on the wall. And these are always lovely, doing a floating cut pour, and I haven't done one for a long time, but they are so popular when you put them up for sale, you know, especially here on the coast where I live. So I'm gonna go back and try and replicate what I was supposed to be filming. So wish me luck. Go for the second one. So here we go. That's just turned out lovely. I'm really, really happy with that. I got all my mess there, but it's no good me cleaning up and trying to. I'm gonna try and replicate it again. Oh, got a bit of dust on there. What's going on? My new studio's almost finished. John's just doing the last coat of paint on the walls. Oh, and then the trim. And the electrician's been today and put me lights in, and so I'm dying to go up there and film and show you again at what stage it's at now. So rightio, back to this. I flooded my canvas with this grey blue. This was a colour I custom made up myself out of, well, it was white, and then I put gold in it, and metallic gold, so it would give it a shimmer. And then I put some cool blue with some a little dab of black, and I'm just tilting it over the canvas just to get a nice coat of paint over my canvas, so when I do come to float my cup over it, the actual, you know, it floats over all this paint that's already on there nice and just the right, not too thick and not too thin, unlike me. Thick, having my video not running when it should have been, but anyway, it's always the way with technology. We've been having so much rain and God knows what that's gone on here at this time, that yeah, the power's been on off. People are in a real well, it's a real catastrophe in Australia in some parts. And it's horrible that people have lost their lives and their homes and their livelihoods. It's very sad, but it is a natural disaster. It's of no causing, or it's not man-made. So it's, I suppose, you know, you've just got to get on with it like we have everything in our life. Rightio, I think that's a nice coat. Just add a little bit. I know it's got a little bit of cream in this, but it's absolutely no matter, because it's an abstract pour and you're doing what you want to do. So I'm going to get a little, it's just a little cardboard cup, 113 mils, I think it said on the side. I'm going to put that forward and I'm going to load my cup up in exactly the same way as I did the previous one. But you can absolutely guarantee that it will not look exactly the same. So I'm going to just pour my paint into the cup. So that is the nice cool blue with gold in it. And this is the metallic copper with a real good dash of metallic pearl in there. I just wanted to dull it down, and then I'm going to put some metallic gold. The metallic gold has got metallic pearl in it as well. I wanted to dull that down, so I'm just literally pouring from a great height here. And some of my nice minky colour, which is metallic pearl with some burnt umber. And then this is, they're all colours, every one of these colours I've custom made. And this one is what I'm calling graphite. It was burnt umber. What did I put in that? I've got it written down somewhere. It was burnt umber, a dob of black and antique gold, and it's made a really nice graphite colour. So I think that that's all I'm putting in this particular one. I think that's good to go. And then I just one last good squirt of white in there. I'm not pouring it down the side of the cup like I probably would normally, just as you see. So I'll bring this back and I'm going to flip the cup and I'm going to float it over the paint. So I'll put a nice layer down to flip my cup onto. No gloves today, so it's just a flip. Ooh! Okay, I didn't do that last time. I'm going to pour some of my grey-blue over it. Ooh! Going a bit AWOL here. And I'm going to take my... Wow. I so love those colours together, but I did a boo-boo there, but I'm sure I will run it off when I tilt the canvas. So, just, these look great on a really nice large canvas, and I really need to do a real big one, but you need somebody to help you tilt, so I'll try and engage some help. Maybe I'll wait till I do my new studio so I've got a nice big piece of art to put on the wall. But I've done a boo-boo there because that's too much. I don't like that. I've got to try and get rid of that, but without losing some of the negative space. Okay, tilt it back. Well, that's not too bad at all. I still prefer my other one, but I'll show you the both of them in a second. So that is not too bad at all. It's got some nice pearly cells coming up underneath there. It's just a normal mixture. I didn't do anything special. Actually, it's really, I think the two of them together side by side, whether in a frame or hung, they would look really lovely. Definitely nice. I'm liking it. Oh. So I'll turn them this way just so I can show you the two together, but they turned out completely different than the other one. Look. So look at that. It has got the same colours, but I still think they'll look lovely together. So I really, really hope those dry nicely, which I think they will. I'll just go around and touch up any areas that you've missed out on, so you get some nice edges drying. But look at those. I mean, I don't do these very often because I'm all into my coloured effects, but those look lovely together. I will bring you down and give you a little look-see. So this was the first one I'd done that the camera wasn't rolling when I did it. I didn't really want cells. I wanted it to more look, you know, fluffy and cloudy, but I absolutely love the colours together. It looks real earthy and something sort of really, earthy and neutral. And that's the first one. I'm coming across to the second one. A lot more of the gold look has shown up. And there's some gorgeous cells in it, but like I said, I didn't really want cells. But it's actually the formation of them just suits this piece. So I'm happy with those. They're lovely. I haven't done these floating cup pours for quite a while. So happy gin. Hope you go. I think I've got my camera the wrong way. Silly Nelly. There you go. Okie doke. I hope you like that. It was something different for me because you know I normally go my nice bright colours. So I'm gonna, you know, you've always got to challenge yourself with things that you're not keen on personally, but these really do sell well living in the beachy area. So my lovelies, please take care of yourself until tomorrow, and I will see you then. Please join me. Bye for now.